Well, we have introduced what we call our own version of our bus rapid transport system, which we christened as REM. And now we are rolling out the second phase of that project. We've also introduced now about 3 weeks ago and the new set of fleet of buses, the REM buses, that are propelled by CNG, compressed natural gas, the first of its kind in sub-Saharan Africa. So in that regard, we are trailblazers. We are involved now in retrofitting all our street lights to LED energy saving. We're spending over $10 million US dollars, but the majority of the rollout will be off balance sheet. We have set up a biomass plant working together with BMW South Africa to meet 30% of the base load of the Rosslyn manufacturing plant of BMW. So these are but a few of the many interventions that we are making to make sure that we transition to a low carbon future. Well, in the first instance, we want to scale up some of the projects that we've already started. Two is that we want to create a funding mechanism. We'll be going out in the debt capital market to raise the green bonds to help us to finance some of these interventions. And also to educate. I think it's important that we're able to educate youngsters so that they have an appreciation of what it means to transition to a low carbon future, growth that reduces the use of fossil fuels. So those are some of the issues that we'll be focusing on going into the future. Well, I guess the biggest barrier is that of capacity, and by capacity I'm referring to both the skills and the finances. I think that's a major hurdle. The second one is the regulatory environment. We need some degree of consent and cooperation with the national government for us to be able to undertake some of these projects. We can generate our own power in terms of our regulation in the country. The ESCOM, which is a state-owned agency, has a monopoly over a generation, so you need to reconfigure the generation element, or if you like, the legal framework, to give effect to local authorities to begin to generate their own power. I guess there are huge opportunities. There's a great appetite globally to fund projects of this nature. There's an enthusiasm to ensure that we upskill municipal employees so that they are properly skilled to be able to package bankable projects that will go out in the debt capital market. But also there's a general appreciation amongst our citizens that this can be the way to go. The energy or climate or change is a new normal, so we need to adapt to that. So I guess that with increased awareness, that there is an opportunity for us to exploit it so that we realize our low carbon growth going into the future.